Hello everyone, in this video we are going to study about the design of butt vents, which are also known as the groove vents. So let's start. So a butt vent or the groove vent, these are provided when the members which are to be connected, they lie along the same line. That means the linearity is present between the connecting members. That means both the plates which are to be connected, they are in the same line of action. Then to fill the gap between them, we provide the groove weld. So basically it is filling out the groove which is present between the connecting members. That's why the name comes as the groove weld. Now these groove welds are provided in the square shape. They are provided in the square shape if the plate that we are connecting, if that is having a size less than 8 mm. And for any size greater than 8 mm, we usually provide either V type of connection or X type of connection or U type of connection. Now these butt welds or the groove welds, they are primarily designed for the direct load, that means direct tension or the compression. So the groove weld, they are designed for direct tension or compression. Although if shear is coming out, then it is not neglected and necessary provisions are made regarding the transmission of the shear force safely. Now we will see certain specification for the groove weld. Now the terminology involved in the designing of the butt welding. So let's say these are the two members which are to be connected and we have connected them with the help of the butt weld. So this is the butt weld which has been provided here. So here the portion of the butt weld which is forming the V shape from plate to plate, that is known as the thickness or the throat thickness of the butt weld. While the top portion which is not involved in the designing process, although this material which has been provided above the level of the plate, this is the level of the plate, so above this the material that we have provided, it is not used in the calculation of the design strength for the welded connection, but it is provided to maintain the efficiency of the joint so that its durability increases. And the bottom portion, the gap between the plates, that is known as the root here, because the actual plates will be in this shape. So this gap is maintained and that is known as the root gap. On this top portion, it is known as the reinforcement. Basically, it is reinforcing the actual connection. It is providing the strength to it, and although that is not included, it is acting like a shield to the actual welded connection. So the first term is regarding the reinforcement. So reinforcement is the extra weld metal which is provided at any connection. Now therefore what we do, we provide 10% greater thickness at any connecting point than what was the desired one, so as to provide for the reinforcement in any butt welding connection. Now the second terminology will be regarding the size of the butt weld. Now the size of the butt weld, it is determined by the throat thickness. That means the thickness of the plate. Because what we are doing here, we are providing the welded connection for the thickness of the plate. Now if the thickness of the plate, if they are varying, let's say this is one plate and this is the another plate which is to be connected. Therefore we will provide the welded connection only at the thickness of the thinner plate, not corresponding to the thickness of the thicker plate, because the rest of the welding material, it will be wasted. Therefore the throat thickness or the size of the weld in this case depends upon the thickness of the thinner member which is to be connected. The size of the weld in case of butt welding, it is decided by the throat thickness. And this throat thickness is dependent upon the thickness of the thinner member. So there are certain provisions in the Indian Standard 800 2007 edition which are made for the necessary size of the butt weld. So the first provision says that the size of the butt weld in this case is taken as equal to the thickness of the thinner plate. This is the first and foremost provision for the adopting the size of the butt weld. Now in the case of the butt weld, when we are connecting two members, we are having two provisions. Let's say these are having equal thicknesses. So either we can provide the material to full thickness or in the halfway. When we are providing for the halfway, then that is known as the incomplete penetration. While if this welded material has been provided throughout the thickness of the plate which is to be connected, then that is known as the complete penetration. So in the case of the butt welding, the effective throat thickness, which is in actual the size of the weld, that is taken as equal to the thickness of the thinner plate in case of only complete penetration and not generally. And what are the examples of the complete penetration? That is double V joint or double U joint. These are the prominent example of the complete penetration in case of butt welding. Other than that, double J and double bevel are also the complete penetration example. Now, if there is incomplete penetration, so in case of incomplete penetration, what we do, the effective throat thickness in this case, that is denoted by TE, it is taken as equal to the 7 by 8 times of the thickness of thinner member. But for calculation purposes, to adopt the higher factor of safety, what we do, the TE value should not exceed 5 by 8 times, it should not exceed the 5 by 8 times the thickness of thinner plate. And if there is a difference between the thicknesses of the plate, then what we do, we need to taper the connection if we want to provide the complete penetration. And this tapering is done at a slope of 1 in 5. Now the next parameter than the throat thickness is the effective length of the weld. So the effective length of the weld, so it is the length for which the effective throat thickness, that is denoted by TE, it exists. It is the length for which effective throat thickness exists. That means the length that we are providing, let's say this is the, I'm trying to show it to you in the three dimension. So this is the length along which welding has been provided. So that means this will be the effective length, because throughout this length, the throat thickness has been maintained. And if we provide some additional welded, and in that case the thickness is not equivalent to the throat thickness, then that will not be included in the effective length, although that will be included in the overall length of the welded connection. So in this case also, the effective length in no case should be less than the 4 times the size of the weld. And in this case, the size of the weld is equal to the throat thickness itself. And if not, then the throat thickness or the length of weld, and in no case this effective length will be taken less than the 4 times the size of the weld, and if not, then we will take it as equal to the 4 times of the size of the weld only. While at the end of the design process, when we draw the actual construction that is to be provided, then we provide the overall length in which the end returns are to be added. That means the overall length will be LE plus 2S, where this 2S is the end returns which are provided to avoid the stress concentration at the end of the joint, because at the termination of the joint there are chances that the rupture may take place or they may start from the end of the connection. Therefore, to avoid that position, we provide the end returns. Now, in the case of the butt weld, last portion or the specification that is to be studied, that is the stresses. Now, in the case of the butt welding, the stresses are taken as equal to the stresses of the parent metal. That means the metal which is used for the connection, that metal will be having certain strength, and that strength value is taken as equal to the strength of the connection. And that is taken when we are using the workshop for the welding purposes. And if this is done in case of field, then these values are reduced by 20%. That means we take the 80% of the value. Now, what is the design strength? So, design strength of the butt weld. The design strength of the butt weld in tension or in compression. Because I've already told you that this design strength is usually measured in tension or the compression. That means the direct load exists in the case of butt weld only. Because the plates are in the same level or in the same line of action. While if they are at different level, then we usually prefer the fillet weld. That's why the shear was existing there, not in this case. So this design strength for the butt weld, that is given by the yielding strength of the connection into the length of the weld, that is known as the effective length, into the size of the weld, that is the effective throat thickness, divided by the gamma MW, which is the partial factor of safety for the welding, which is taken as equal to 1.25 in case of the workshop weld and taken as equal to 1.50 in case of the field weld. Now this Fy is the minimum of the yield stress of parent metal or the weld material. Whichever is having the lesser value of the yield stresses, that will be taken as equal to the Fy value. Now in case there is a possibility that the load that we are providing, that is generating the shear force, in that case the design strength in shear is also to be calculated, and that is given by the relation, that is VDW, that is given by Fy divided by root 3. This root 3 factor is taken for the shear. This is studied in the case of the strength of material when we study about the theories of failure, in which we study about the maximum stress theory. So that designates that the design value is taken as equal to the ultimate value, that is the yield value, divided by the root 3. This root 3 factor is taken from there. Into the area over which it is acting, that is the length of the weld, into the thickness of the weld, that is TE, divided by the partial factor of safety. So this gives us the value of the design strength of the butt weld in case of shear. So this is for the butt weld only. Now when we are designing the joint, we need to consider the resultant force. That's why the consideration has to be taken for the resultant. Let's say there is no uniformly distributed load and the load which is applied here, that is an individual one. Therefore the stress due to the individual load, that may be because of the compression or because of the tension, that is given by Fa, that is the axial load, or that is represented by Q, and that will be the applied load divided by the area of the weld, which is the length of the weld into the effective throat thickness. So this will give us the calculated or simply the normal stress because of the individual load. Now when we study about the connection, therefore we need to instruct about the combination of the stresses, because ultimately the design has to be in such a way that the design strength is exceeding the externally applied load. That means the capacity is more than the actual load which is placed on the connection. So for that we need to understand about the resultant values. So when we are dealing about the combination of the stresses, the stress may be because of the direct load which is coming onto the connection because of the tension or compression, or it may be because of the shear force. So when we are talking about the compression or tension, then that will be a normal stress. while in case of the shear force, then we will be having the shear stress. So in actual, the resultant will be taken, which will be the combination of these two stresses. So the equivalent or the resultant value that is given by the relation, that is the normal stress square plus 3 times the square of the shear stress. And in total, this value should be less than the ultimate value divided by root 3 divided by gamma mw. This is the important equation for the actual calculation, because ultimately we need to understand about the resultant only. So this is very important in the case of the fillet weld, because in that there are chances of both the forces, and in case of the butt weld there are lesser chances for the existence of the both the forces. Now the last type of connection that were there, that is the plug and slot weld. So whenever, let's say this is one plate that we are connecting with the another gusset plate. So this is the length along which we have provided the welding. This is the length along which the welding has been provided. In case of the butt welding or the fillet welding, let's say this was the length which was available to us. So let's say this is 10, this is 100, and this is 20. That means the overall length will be, here in this case, that is 130. That is 130 units. In case we want our, the required length is equal to 200 millimeter or something of that value. In that case, we cannot change the plate section or the type of connection. So to make the necessary adjustment, what we do, we provide the gusset plate at the same place, the actual plate at the same place. The only thing that we now can change to increase this effective length of the weld, so we will provide slots here depending upon the requirement of the length. So now the actual length that will be provided, it will be 10 millimeter on the top and 20 at the bottom, while this vertical direction, that is still conserved, that means this is length, this is the length, this is the length. So in total this length has been conserved and it is still 100 units. That means this is also conserved. That means we have not wasted 130 millimeter. But in addition to that, what we have done, we have provided this, this, and these values for the extra welding. Let's say this is, let's say this length is 15 millimeter. So that means the 4 times the 15, this will be giving us the 60 millimeter weld. That means now we have increased this actual length of welding, which was 130 to 190 millimeter, which is very close to the required length. So now if we are not achieving the required length, that means again we will perform the trial and error and we will increase the length of these slots so as to obtain the required length of the weld. So this is how we provide the slot weld. And in case of the plug weld, we provide a hole at the top plate and along the periphery of these plates we provide the weld, and this is known as the plug weld, while this type of weld which is provided through the slot, that is known as the slot weld. Now we will look at the design problems based upon the butt weld and the plug and slot weld one by one in the next video. So thank you.